For his reaction on this, we are joined by Attorney Bert Estrada. He is the president of the Integrated Bar of the Philippines. Good morning, Attorney Estrada, and thanks for joining us today. Attorney Estrada, can you hear me?
Yes. Good morning, Stanley.
Good morning. Welcome to the show. Yes, thanks for joining us. Reduced coverage, shortened duration of the 2020-2021 bar exams because of the COVID surge, and of course, in the aftermath of Typhoon Odette. Do you think this is the most feasible arrangement to balance the challenges and still push through with the bar exams?
Yes, Stanley. We have always, the IBPS, supported the Supreme Court in its quest for reforms in the bar exams. And in the past months, we have a number of times mentioned our support to these reforms to make the exams more equitable through the digitalization and localization. And these new challenges brought about by the Omicron strain and the damage brought about by the Typhoon Odette, we can only imagine the additional hardships that it has on the examinees. But however, we understand that the Supreme Court has had its consultation with the different law deans, especially in the areas affected by the typhoon. And right, as mentioned in the resolution by the court, there's a need to strike a balance between these additional challenges and the need and the demand for new lawyers in the land. We have not produced any new lawyers in the last 2 years, and this is something that has to be addressed. And we believe that in the wisdom of the court in striking this balance and coming up with this remedy.
Okay, Attorney Estrada, a month ago, there were already speculations of a postponement, even a cancellation of the bar exams until the Supreme Court, of course, made its final decision yesterday. And the decision is to cut the exam dates, merge some subjects. Now, did you see this kind of solution coming? What other options should have been explored?
But to be perfectly honest, I did not see it coming that it would be resolved this way, but I do see the wisdom in it. And as always mentioned by the Supreme Court and especially the bar chairman, Justice Leonin, that the bar exam is really just a qualifying exam, a licensure exam, to be able to practice the bar. And so it is just meant to test the minimum qualification of a person to practice law. And it's not a competition amongst law students, but just a mere qualifying exam to determine the competence of a person to practice law in the Philippines. So I do applaud the solution, and I've looked at the reduced coverage, and we believe that our students, our examinees, would have had prepared, had enough time to prepare for these exams, and we hope that we do have more lawyers in the coming months.
Okay, tell us a bit about the coverage of the condensed subjects. Is this something that, of course, you've said earlier that the examinees are ready, they have prepared for this? How tough or maybe easy or tricky would the exams be? And where do you think the passing rate is headed, up or down, given the new style?
Having read the previous bar matters issued by the Supreme Court and the recent one, my personal opinion is that and as explained in the if there are even example questions, that it is really meant to just focus on the fundamental principles of law, to really test, to just be a, to test the minimum skills required of a lawyer. So there has been example questions, and the court has been very transparent on how it will grade the answers of the examinees. And I think it will work to the benefit of the examinees, as they will just be graded as either satisfactory, not satisfactory, and excellent. No? So I think it will work to the advantage of the law students, as they will really focus on the fundamental principles of the law.
All right. You've been through the bar exams yourself. It was a tough bar exam. It wasn't like this. Now, will the reduction of coverage affect the quality of the bar exams itself and, of course, the lawyers that we will be producing?
I believe not, Stanley, no, because as I mentioned, our law students have graduated 4 years in law school, have mm-hmm. already reviewed the longest time that they are in review, and so the test is just to determine their minimum skills, their knowledge of the fundamental principles of the law, and so this shortened and reduced coverage of the exam, I think, will still have the result of determining whether a person has the minimum skills to be a member of the bar.
Okay, there were calls to postpone the bar exams, particularly in areas stricken by Typhoon Odette, while others say they could not afford another postponement. Now, other challenges include, of course, telecommunications and power, which may not have been fully restored. Add to that the mandatory COVID testing, both RT-PCR and antigen tests for the vaccinated and unvaccinated. And how would these challenges take a toll on the mental and emotional state, perhaps, of the examinees?
Yes, we did receive these letters from even from some of our chapters. Mm-hmm. And as I mentioned earlier, we can only imagine these additional hardships. However, as we've learned, that consultations were done by the Supreme Court with different law deans, we believe that the needed technology and infrastructure are intact before they decided to proceed with these exams. As to the RT-PCR and the antigen tests, I remember the bar chairman stating that this will be shouldered by the Supreme Court, the expenses shouldered by the Supreme Court. But yes, it will pose, we cannot say that it will not pose additional challenges. It mm-hmm. will really pose additional challenges, but we just hope that it is not so insurmountable and that the examinees, especially in these affected areas, can surpass this additional challenge and really have a good exams and get to where they want to be, to become members of the bar.
All right, Attorney Estrada, one of the reasons the Supreme Court is bent on, of course, pushing through with the bar exams is meeting the demand for new lawyers, as you also mentioned earlier. Now, how big is the demand exactly, and how has the pandemic affected your profession?
Yes, based on the numbers, Stan, we have only about 40,000 lawyers, and based on how many are in good standing, there are only about 25,000 lawyers that are mm-hmm. updated in paying their membership fees or are in good standing. So if we equate that to the number of Filipinos, let's say 110 Filipinos, that's only about one lawyer for every 4,400 Filipinos. We've seen, especially in the rural areas, that there are only a handful of lawyers mm-hmm. in one province. There's really a need for more lawyers, especially during this time of emergency and pandemic, Stanley.
All right. Lastly, and as a parting shot, what is your message of inspiration to aspiring lawyers in their upcoming exam in about 2 weeks?
Yes, I've always mentioned to the aspiring lawyers that in aspiring, in having our ambitions, we do not center it on the self, but have it centered on others. Aspire to be a member of a community, to be able to help others, and your aspirations will bring you to the stars.
On that note, yes, thank you, Attorney Estrada, for your insights and, of course, for your time. Stay safe.
Thank you so much.